nowadays that's the American way.
Bluey.
With this false administration that has led us astray. They want the country to heal, but they don't spell with an A.
Oh, yes! Yes!
That's brilliant!
That's brilliant, wow. Yes!
Let's talk about facts.
If you want to have intellectual discussions.
Spiritually oriented.
A beautiful family.
Who you are beyond a personality.
I'm a human being, same as you.
Be who you are.
But to answer your question.
What is really going on?
And let's get into this.
And what is happening, Wirgo Warriors? Welcome to the wonderful world of Wirgo, the place where we get asked what is really going on. Today we're going to be doing a reaction and review with myself, Carl, and...
Alyssa.
Love her. Tom, what are we reviewing today, babe?
We are reviewing a song by someone called Chris Webby, and it's called Raw Thoughts 5.
Now, we haven't heard Chris Webby before, although we do feel we may have heard snippets of his song on certain things, because some parts of it seemed like we may have heard it before, but we're not sure yet, from what we've been told of it. Now, do you want to tell them why we're doing this song?
Because someone requested it. One of our wonderful Wirgo Warriors requested
So, one of you lovely Wirgo Warriors out there requested us to do Raw Thoughts, and I'm always in our chat, right? I'm always doing comments and things. Lisa takes care of the Facebook side, and we're standing...
TikTok
as well, because we want to do lives as we do this and lots of other things. Because there's so much coming up, it's hard to explain all, and I'm not going to bore you all again. Right? But you just have to wait till it comes up. This show is not about... This is just like a little thing, get us started. We've got podcasts, we've got out meeting people, talking to people, real people, cities, schools, high schools. We say high schools because a lot of Americans, and for us, obviously... We'll say comprehensive schools over here, the public schools, going down to college. We've got lots on coming up, and we'll get into all that with all your great questions. We let you guys ask the questions as well in most of the cases. But we have been asked a question now as, what about Chris Webby's Raw Thoughts? Because we was doing some stuff with Tom McDonald with me, and we're big, huge fans of Tom McDonald. And someone said, this guy is like Tom 2.0, you need to listen to this guy. Now we was like, oh, okay, but this might be an opportunity for us to do an actual reaction that we haven't to something we haven't seen yet.
Yeah.
And we have been told by a few others that there's some explicit language, a lot of it apparently. And we are putting a warning up now. We are not blurring out all the explicit language.
Mm.
It is raw. We are giving it to you as we see it, how it is comes to us on YouTube. So guys, big warning, please, you have children. You may want to remove them unless, of course, you've had that talk to explain them about what we refer to as potty words, and why they're done, how they put in art form. Parent your children how you wish. But we're giving you this warning right now for myself and Lisa. Should be a warning on it coming up on your screen. Warning! Your children may, this may not be suitable for your children, or should we say individuals that are vulnerable.
Yeah.
Vulnerable individuals. Let you make the decision, because let's face it, a lot of the world are not letting you make the decisions of your own children nowadays, are they? So at least Wirgo will always offer you that. All right, so guys, we are not blurring out the words and stuff like that. And if yourself is not into this kind of thing, you're Christians and you don't want this kind of thing, switch off. All right, go to the next episode, check something out. This is just a review on a song by Chris Webby, Raw Thoughts, for either of it, and we've been warned a lot of potty mouth.
Mm-hmm.
So we are going to get into character to allow that to wash over us, because we understand why people put it in. Frustrations, maybe people want to get out their emotions. And we've been told Raw Thoughts is like, not like a track this gentleman reads, because we was asking, why the hell is it 7.5 minutes long? And they're like, no, it's kind of like the gentleman, he does a cut. We're gonna try and look through all the Raw Thoughts, aren't we, as well, if this one is good. We've been promised it is, so if we like Tom, apparently we're going to love it, so we're kind of excited. Right, would you say that?
Yeah.
And I'm going to say that... His Raw Thoughts, sorry, are just, he gets out on paper the things he's thinking about in the world. And this is number 5, and we've told, because it's to do with like the Biden administration, things like that. And we want to see, come on, what's he going to say about all this? And everything that's going on. So, guys, these are Chris Webby's Raw Thoughts. And me and Lisa have decided today we want to listen to his thoughts and we want to comment on them. So, we probably won't stop as many times because this is 7 minutes, but then knowing me. Want to get in this, babe? It's good. She's excited. Come on, I want to see this. She loves Tom and all that. Right, here we go.
There's a lot of opinions floating around these days. And I got my own. You know, they may not be publicly acceptable. They may get me canceled.
Ooh.
But it's my goddamn American right to speak.
Liking us already.
And if you got a problem with that, suck my dick.
All right, they weren't lying. I think we all know what that, the ick that's going to follow the D, right? Yeah. Wow, straight away. Okay, guys.
We did warn you.
Yeah, I'm going to have to drop into character now. I don't want to be pulling this up every single time. No. Guys, I'm just going to accept the language of profanity in this, and that's what it's about. It's an art style when it comes to rap. They're expressing their passions. I think it could be done a little bit more tasteful, but hey, I'm not Chris Webby, and he's making success. How many views on this?
6.6. 6.6 million views a year ago.
And 1,000... What am I talking about? 152,000 likes.
Yeah.
So, guys, there's a lot of people that connect with this track, yeah? So, let's see how you feel. Here we go.
Dick. In a world made for the weak, the meek, the beta males and the sheep. Too soft for debate. If they don't agree, then they just block and try to censor whatever you speak. Only like minds on the timeline that they see. They anti this and anti that. So close-minded, really, they just anti-facts. And you can show them the proof. But if it doesn't all align with their views that they've been programmed with from the news.
Can you spot a lie so far? Oh my goodness.
Factual.
Right, guys, when we say factual, we should point out really, and be honest, but we always pull this up with other people, that it's factual to us. Mm. I can relate a lot to this. Don't get me, guys, right. To me, this is all still the narrative, still a fake world, but within the fake world that the majority of us live in, this seem like facts to me. Mm. This is how I'm experiencing life now. Guys, right down below, just that first bit. Is anybody else experiencing this? No matter which side of the aisle you're on, I think that's the way to say it, isn't it? Whether you believe it's against someone else or against you, whatever. Yeah. Can you see what he's saying? All right, I'm already enjoying this. This is going to be really
good. They don't want to hear it or even fucking be near it. See, the truth is too much for their spirit. That's why they fear it. They try to tell me no, but fuck it, I'm going to say it anyway. I've been waiting for the government to kill me any day. What the fuck? I'm not important enough. Must I talk about the vax, how they poisoning us? Or the Vatican and all the little boys that they touch?
Ooh!
Ooh!
I'm not rewinding that back.
Ooh.
I think we all hear that. Ooh! That was a dig. That was a dig, wasn't it? I was going to pause it to say about the vax and that, but then he just went straight into the Vatican.
No filter.
Oh my god, this is by the way, guys, I'm gonna have a no filter kind of sign coming up soon for myself. I might do that for him, actually, because it would sign it for me. This is it. We're gonna have a no filter sign for you, Carl, but wow, no filter. Well, it's raw thoughts. I get what he's saying with raw thoughts, though, now that's making a lot more sense to me. Like, they're just raw, this is what's spitting from him. Spitting, no pun intended.
I'm not scared, shit. It's not like I'm avoiding this stuff. Yeah, the First Amendment still lives on through me and certain other motherfuckers. Who ain't on TV.
I love that.
That's
a museum.
Yeah, like a museum, and he's a free thinker. Yes, the future they are extinct, baby.
That's so good.
That's me.
Yeah.
Me, that, eh? And you're just looking at me. Oh, well done, I love that.
That's awesome.
I like that.
That's so
free
good.
Finger, that's clever.
The last dinosaurs alive in AD. When we're gone, then you'll really know that freedom ain't free. But
yeah.
If everybody got to show them some balls, these agendas they've been pushing will be slow to a crawl.
Can I just point out really quickly, though? This idea of free thinkers and all that going extinct. That's what I truly believe when the last two pillars of freedom leave this world within the narrative. See, the narrative is all built up on stories, right?
Yeah.
And people like religious people, it's not true, but it is, because these people live in the world where this is true. They don't live in the hymn where this is not true. And like I said, you know, I think the world is falling into Babylon right now, which we'll explain another time. But listen, the last two pillars of freedom within the narrative are the First and Second Amendment of America. The only reason the rest of us aren't, you don't know, like the guys, if you're in America right now, you do not understand the freedoms we don't have that you do. That we cut, like, I can write something on Facebook that's mean, and a policeman can come to my house and give me a fine, possibly even give me a court date. I have to go speak. Basically, if you think what's happening in Jordan Peterson, going to be trained again on how to speak to people or socially acceptable stuff. If you think that's Canada, that's like they're getting their stuff. UK, I think, is more down that line and that, and so a lot of Europe. What do you think? You've seen all these riots and things in Europe and that. They all have their different headlines, but they're about the same thing. Now, the reason they don't plunge us fully into darkness, we're going to do a whole episode on this, is simply this. Because the Americans still have two pillars of freedom that stand within the narrative that hold them up. They call them the First and Second Amendment. We the people, you all know about that, yeah? It's a part of their narrative that isn't going away yet, but they're trying to get rid of it. And as soon as one of those pillars falls, the other one will. Without a shadow of doubt, one pillar falls, the other one will. They hold each other up. And all Americans, I think, understand this.
Yeah.
The rest of us don't. We're made to fear this thing or make it look like it's stupid, but I see through all that. Mm. It's not stupid within the narrative. The narrative is held together by stories and words and what you guys put down on paper as laws and things. And one of the greatest... people, everybody's got a constitution. Well, where's my constitution to uphold my right to defend myself against people I believe to be corrupt? I haven't got a choice in that. Big Brother controls me over here. Well, I let Big Brother think it controls me, and I allow it to have some sort of control of me so I can do what I'm supposed to do.
Yeah,
which will
dip
come
into society. I've known it.
Even Neo had to go back into the Matrix to help you. Don't see myself as being any different, although I'm not Neo, okay? I don't know what I'm saying. Oh, but you're so fucking soft, obeying and going along. Keep getting the swearing. Sitting there triggered over a song. I need a type. Got a Black Lives Matter sign on the front porch. Never had a black person in the house. Yes.
Oh,
that's so true. I love that. Strength I've said that before though. To other people as well. Friends of mine that I don't class people as black and white, guys, but those you would see as black. And actually, some of my friends never really identified themselves as black people. I suppose we have a different culture here in our country to you do in America because you're past.
Yeah.
Here, the Welsh were the N-words, as you call them, because... that could be another episode where we show how our kind were treated the same way as they believe their kind were, like Kamanatra and things like that.
Yeah.
You know, where they would sleep with your wife on the night of your wedding. Mm. So they're the English lords, the first one to sleep with your wife. Now, you want to talk about cruelty. We can talk about that, but nobody has to go back there. So, we've spoken about things like that, individuals you may identify as black, and they said the same thing. Yeah, I said, mad how many people won't actually talk to someone they identify as a black person, or accept their views, and yet they're willing to do this stuff with virtue signal. So
it's time to call.
I get what he's talking about. I'm out. Virtue signal motherfuckers ain't about shit. They just running at the mouth with these pre-programmed points of view and these ludicrous facts. Asian hate, stop acting like you knew about that. If you need to say,
I
don't know much about Asian hate. I think
it's
an American thing. We don't.
A bit ignorant there, I'm afraid.
The Asians we get over here, I think everybody's okay. All right, you do hear, and guys, I'm going to go into character mode now. 1 minute, it's not coming from me. Acting! You
Ego.
Do hear horrific comments, ready? Like, are you pee... I shouldn't really say it. I find it difficult to say.
It's hard,
you
isn't it?
You know, people here know, and you all... right, guys. In most cases, not a form of racism, even though it looks like that. It's a form of narcissistic abuse.
Mm.
They're just looking for the easiest thing to attack you on.
Yeah.
If it looks like your skin, you're sensitive to it, they'll use it. They don't really actually care.
Mm.
Right, but yeah, so you do see a lot of prejudice towards individuals who are different. But guys, that happens. Like, I've been autistic pretty much my whole life. No one really knew about it. But if I told you some stories, you'd go, "How didn't they know?" I know. But like, anyway, I've been bullied all my life, child abuse, all sorts of things. Like that. Never sexual, but other things. But do you know what I mean? So I don't know. Space. There's some room in the back with fresh vaginal wipes you could use while I rap. Yeah, it helps them all sleep at night. Know when they signed a petition for equal rights for transgenders, talking like it's their fight, when in reality they never met one another.
I love that.
Said the same thing for not Chris, dead name. Jess. Said the same Jess when she was here. Like, and we've had like trans people on our show and stuff.
Yeah.
I mean, said the same thing to them. Amount of people don't have a transgender friend or someone going through it.
Mm.
Not you have to have that to have an opinion. But then they give theories and facts on it, like, you've never probably met one in your life.
Yeah.
I have a deep friend who has gender dysphoria, and, well, she doesn't necessarily make the greatest efforts to look like a woman, but, because she's a mechanic, she's boisterous.
Had all the surgeries, so.
But she's had the surgeries, and we call her she's had the surgeries. And it, to me, it's just a narrative thing.
Yeah.
I can't say she's a female.
No.
I know that's confusing to her, but that's Babylon, isn't it? Babylon is the confusion of the word.
Yeah.
She's a Babylonian. And she believes she's a she. And I don't want to push on that illness, but never will Jess ever be able to come here and get me to say that she's a female.
No.
I can't confuse the word of God.
But she respects that also, doesn't she?
Yeah,
you know,
I will not go back on the word of God. You can suck my if you think I'll do that. No, that isn't happening. But I will go back on the word of man. because they're just made up. They're just narrative. It's narrative, guys. Yeah. But when we apply narrative, which is non-narrative, when we apply mathematical coding to that which we see as the him, that which is here before us, that which is created by God, not us. God created everything almost male and female, and the very small portion in between that seems to get on that balance in between both, we'd refer to that as what we call an abnormality, like myself. I'm an abnormality. I don't mind being abnormal. I love being different and abnormal. It's great. I think you normalies are weird. But none of you are normal. You're all on the spectrum somewhere. Just some of you are just more inclined to look like each other than some of us.
All of your own uniqueness.
There should never be any bullying for this kind of thing, but I don't think there should ever be any lies about it. Just say it as it is. Yeah. Why people have it? Is the people
it's
who... I find the people who want to cover it up like the way they do are the people more into the bullying than anything else because they believe in that stuff. Why? Look, guys, you can never make me think that Jess is a female.
No.
But I'll say it's a woman. She acts and dresses like a woman when she wants to be treated like a woman. She's getting very feminine. Go on, Ben.
But she, you know, she has turned around to us, though, and said that because we've always known her as a man, sometimes it can slip up.
Oh,
your programming,
you know,
do you know what I mean? So but, I mean, sometimes I'll say he or Chris or...
She is in it because... She is in it. Chris, Jess, he, she, whichever you want, because if people are either he or whatever. They're in it.
She understands.
They are in it because they know they have a mental illness that makes them feel like feminine, and they're more comfortable living that way. I don't want to stop people living comfortable, but it's like I said, it's the moment these people are they're not comfortable because they can't make you see what they want you to see. That they're narcissistic individuals. You can get narcissistic transgenders and empathic transgenders. I have guaranteed that. Yeah, exactly. I can guarantee. Nobody has a problem with empathic transgenders unless they've got some sort of traumas hidden in them, which is then, I'm not talking about those individuals. Most of us love empathic transgenders. They're just wonderful.
Blair White, one of my favourites. I should have favourites, but I love her.
Blair White, I think, is a very ethical person, but she also has a lot of narcissistic, and which is part of her feminine qualities, but she portrays herself as female.
She looks female.
But that woman will never ever tell you that she was born a woman. She'll never ever tell you that she's male, female. She will always tell you that I'm a male who's transitioned into being a woman. Because a woman is a made-up thing. It's a role that you play. She wants to play that role. She feels comfortable in that way. That's great. She doesn't push her ideology on anybody. No. If you're there not allowing Christians to push their ideologies on you with their stuff, then why are you allowing transgender to do it? I don't get it. And you normally find the Christians that don't push it on you, that just show you a good life, are the empathical ones or more neutral ones. And the ones that just push on you are narcissistic. People are not looking at the world the way I am. And seeing narcissism versus empathy in those cases. I don't see the versus.
Just that understanding and compassion, isn't it, from others? When it comes to this sort of subject, love and compassion.
Acceptance, appreciation, and awareness.
Yeah.
Love.
Yeah.
Right.
Little life, they don't donate or actually do nothing about it. They just sit there, sipping Mountain Dew on their couches while they clapping for each other and circle jerking themselves. Applaud the loss of freedom and cancel those who rebel. And I'm the bad guy because I'm white and not gay, which means that I'm a bigot and discredits what I say. But
I agree, yeah.
I'd rather have some toxic masculinity than have an inner bitch in me.
Can I return it on the other side, though, just for Chris there, and for others to show I'm fair? If you're white and you're straight or whatever, again, you're narrowing it, Christian. Yeah? You're putting in a box to get it for the song. I'm just saying for those who want to look at this logically. He's doing exactly the same thing. There's narcissistical white straight men and women who do horrific narcissistic things, but he's turning a blind eye to that. They're not talking about you, Chris, but they act like they are. You should pull out that fact. You're not talking about me, you're talking about others, so stop labeling me. When you say white and straight, you are talking about every white straight individual in the world. It's completely... you're complaining about the same thing on the other side.
Yeah.
And you're doing it yourself.
Yeah.
So, Chris, say to you as well, buddy. Mention something about the fact that you're not narcissistic, you're not prejudiced, so therefore you shouldn't be labelled the others, but there are individuals like that. When you don't mention that, it makes the other side go, see, he's doing it as well. Stop mocking, Carl. He's doing it as well. And I can't.
Yeah.
Because I've got to go into that character, see, babe. Look, at the end of the day, it's same on both sides, guys.
Bitch, so suck a dick of three. See, the algorithm's keeping you lost, and now you're caught in an echo chamber of your own thoughts. Let me talk while I can and speak to all my supporters before there's lawyers, threats, and gag orders. Because now Nowadays, that's the American way.
Bluey.
With this false administration that has led us astray. They want the country to heal, but they don't spell with an A.
Oh, yes! Yes!
That's brilliant.
That's brilliant. Wow. Yes! Yeah, oh, I love that. I'm going to use that.
That's
more
amazing.
I want a top with that on. I'm going to make some great tops for us once I get Brandon into it. Oh, I love that.
That was awesome.
I love that. Oh, well done.
What they mean is to obey and do whatever they say.
I'm going
to
rewind that back. Sorry. Sorry.
So when I'm here to rap, I've got to obey and do with this administration that has led us astray. They want the country to heal, but they don't spell with an A. What they mean is to obey and do whatever they say. But we tired of that. So when I'm here to rap, I got a duty to the people to bring light to the facts. Never see a day I'm taking it back. If I gave a shit, then I'd use a mask for wiping my ass.
I didn't get that then. What do you? I didn't know what you said then. Sorry, something about the shot. I think it was. Who's the shot? Who's the shot? If I did it, I'm not understanding the logic. Shit, it's such a hot topic, you can get them in laws. I just got my 8th booster. Fucking round of applause. I'm scared to say it, so they just say nothing instead. So let me make myself clear so they don't twist what I said. Hell yeah, I'll get the shot with a gun to my head. After they pull the trigger and they vaccinate me dead. I want a badge of honour that says, unvaccinated.
Oh, my God. Yeah.
No, guys, I don't rub it in. People out there go, I'm not trying to do that. I'm just characterising. Right? I get it. People have fears because they're driven into you. I don't want to make those people my enemy. No. And so many influencers are. And things like this does. I'll give a slight apology to those who think they're offended over this, right? But all I'm trying to say is I'm going along the character and the jokes. It is funny to me because that's the way I see the world. But it's obviously not funny to you. I get that. There are things funny to others and not funny to me. I'm saying there is a way to heal this. I mean, just talk facts, not Babylonian. Mm. But people don't. Narcissistic individuals want to speak Babylonian. I'll lay something out, and instead of addressing it, they'll just go, you're just... And it's like, oh, bro... Put no structure to your words, no structure to your sentences, your paragraphs, your theories, anything. And then you expect me to understand it. I can't. I'm autistic. Everything is mathematical to me. If it's not mathematical and it doesn't fall within the trinity of a positive, negative...
Neutral.
Positive, negative, neutral. Sorry, yes. I'm running too fast in my head. If it doesn't come in that form, I won't be able to see it correctly. Oh, he's telling me I thought he was having fun.
I could just feel his energies just going up and around.
Yeah. But, go into it. Oh, fuck. Oh, he's been... Goosebumps. He's got goosebumps.
Goosebumps. Shove it up your ass.
Oh, y'all thought I was done?
3 minutes in.
Hell no.
Oh,
this
my
is
word.
Thoughts.
Oh, yeah, I thought I was watching that for it's ages in. Oh, my God, we're not halfway through. Oof. I gotta stop this. I gotta stop stopping it, babe.
You know how we do. Line these motherfuckers up. It's time to get to work. Where should I start? Joe Biden, I guess. Old Yeller. Shit, I'm honestly surprised he hasn't died on us yet. You ain't a president, dog. Shit, you don't have to pretend. Come on, Joe. We all know that you ain't actually win. Yeah, them puppet strings holding you up. Weak in the Bernies. Dementia really slowing you up. Should we be worried? You're tripping upstairs. Then you're sniffing on hair. So go and get...
Oh, my God. God, whoever forwarded this to us, I wish I knew your name. Thank you so much.
Whichever Wirgo warrior out there told us to do this, thank you.
Oh my God, this is amazing.
Oh, this guy's awesome. I gotta listen more of his stuff, man.
Oh my God, I
want
to listen to more now. Yeah. Wow.
All right, we understand. It was that was clearly jokes.
Oh God.
Oh my God.
I love this.
Oh, I'm not crying. Well, I am, but no.
Get this geriatric man a wheelchair, and then you got his son making lots of loot from the geriatric man a wheelchair.
We all know
that you ain't actually win. Yeah, them puppet strings holding you up. Weak in the Bernies, dementia really slowing you up. Should we be worried? You're tripping upstairs, then you're sniffing on hair. Someone go and get this geriatric man a wheelchair, and then.
Honestly, you write some bars. I know that's more of a comical one, not a.
You got a son making lots of loot from the Ukraine and blew it on prostitutes. So I'll snort a line of crack rock off the protective case of...
So desensitized this now, it's been everywhere, but it's good, it's good writing.
I'm Hunter Biden's laptop, so I'm typing in caps lock like, hi Fauci, I seen that mail leak, dog. Better get a better antivirus called a Geek Squad.
Geek Squad, ah!
Last time I seen it.
Oh my god.
Oh, do you know what? Nobody actually made me laugh like this within a song and feel relatable since Tom McDonald, actually.
Definitely.
So whoever wrote this was
Tom McDonald
right.
2.0, definitely.
Yeah.
I get it now when they say, you think Tom McDonald's a biz? Like, check these guys out. And I'm like,
oh no, Tom McDonald.
I mean, he is awesome, but yeah, like this is like raw. Like, you know what I mean?
Fake, girl.
Like, I mean, I'm not knocking him, but Jesus, the way he words
I love the boy. He's good. Like, he's got my attention. You just have been putting Tom down.
I'm not putting him down.
Hog fan. Get on her page. Start telling her.
That many wrong numbers was me when I failed math class. And Jen Psaki, I'm getting sick of that lying twat fire crotch. Always trying to tell me they'll require shots. But if it's shots that they want, I'll let them have it. If they knocking on my door, checking my vaccine status. Andrew Cuomo, grabbing asses like the old days. Still had time to kill more old...
I will say one thing about this that I don't feel is in Tom's. First of all, obviously he's projecting emotions way more because it's raw fought. We get
more
that.
Potty in
there, so yeah, a lot more potty mouth. But also the fact that there is a lot of violent insinuation in this, which we don't like in other rap songs.
No, that's true.
So we must say that to all the Chris Webby fans. Unfortunately, not happy with the insinuation of violence, but you understand it's an art form.
Yeah.
So not mocking the man or putting him down and saying, I wish he could find a better way to express this, but might not just be a style. Maybe he doesn't want to go down the Tom McDonald route in that way.
Yeah.
You know, maybe this is saying, no, this is me. So, okay, yeah, okay, get that. But I'm just saying, that's what I would prefer, but like, shut up, Carl, it's not about you. Yeah.
People in old age, we all hate you, judge and defame you. I speak for all Italians, we don't claim you. Injected Rachel Maddow with a fatal strain of mad cow. Walked her up a massive flight of steps and kicked her back down. See your news come out, make me want to smack the dick right out of Anderson Cooper's mouth. So ask your senator, pass me the AstraZeneca.
I am feeling all these Ozzy trying to write, but they're just... They're good. They're just like high school bars at the moment, which is cool. But it's nice he puts, you know, he's not going to write every bar perfect, you know what I mean? But and they all go in together and it's flowing beautifully. Mm. So I'm not mocking, I'm just saying that some of the bars I'm just going to smile to, others are going to crease me because they're just like, I feel they're unique and like, oh my God, yes, they're so glad to see.
Covax, your relative's dad, go and jab your stepmother rapid, testing your ass when you have a temperature shit. We gone nuts, don't vax the messenger. Not Kamala Harris and Guantanamo Barrack. She's incarcerated so many people, I think it merits. Leaving her there to rot, she deserving.
Yeah, that's a very strange thing to me. I've always wanted to bring that up. In fact, I'm glad he's just did that. I'm sorry, there was some great points he was actually getting up. That's something that I want to talk about, is why is it that the people that refer to themselves as black people, why do they love this Kamala Harris so much when she was like a massive proponent for putting what they refer to as, I don't do the air quotes, Carl, people have said they don't like that. Sorry, guys, I air quote things when I don't understand it that well, so I do that. I go, like, I'd say black people. I'm not, to me, they don't exist, but I'm not saying you don't exist. I'm just saying you look at yourself in a way I wouldn't look at you.
You label it like...
Yeah, you label yourself
label.
A different label to me.
Yeah.
I want to use your label so you know what I'm talking about, but they're not my labels, so I do that. So if other people do it for other reasons or mean something else, sorry about that. Explain it to me, I'll stop.
Yeah.
But some people have said, don't do that, Carl, because it makes people feel like you're not saying they exist. And that's not what I'm saying. I'm saying you don't exist the way you think you exist to me. Mm. I think you'd exist in a completely different and beautiful way. So... she put so many of the people they class as, here we go, their people, because it's all our people, guys, put them away in jail for, like, cannabis for years and stuff. I mean, why are you going to jail for cannabis? I don't get that. Selling it to minors and all that kind of thing, fine. You get caught with it, fine. As in, fine, have a fine or whatever, you know, if it's a punishment they want to stop people from doing. But, like... That to me would be a big no, and I would just never, that person wouldn't get my vote.
No.
They would show that they're completely controlled by the establishment.
Yeah.
That someone who classes herself as a guy, here comes the air quotes, don't mean to upset people, but like, you know, she classes herself as a black woman with black issues, that feels the black problem. I just don't agree these are the terms you use. I see them as different terms we'll discuss another time. And yet, those who class themselves as black people voted for this woman, who's doing everything they said not they didn't want to do. So that I don't understand at all. And then when I looked at it, it was in, I think, Ted Cruz and all that were questioning her about all this stuff and all that. And, like, it's there. She didn't deny it. She said, I was following the law, I was following this. And I'm thinking... Right, guys, the camera's just gone off again. What we think we know the issues with it. We have, like, a few battery and issues that when it goes out, when our battery heats up a certain amount, it's switching itself off. Because we use cheap batteries. All right? We'll get a few more subs, right, and we'll get the right... No, we get better batteries, right? We think that's the problem. So it means every now and again we have to re-bloody do this. But I'm noticing when it goes off now, and it just went off, I think, roughly when I was chatting about the fact that about Kamala Harris and how we don't know how people voted for her in England. And people, she's a black woman, you're racist. It's like, no, there are plenty of individuals of class. And says, but, I mean, look at Candy Lake and all that.
Yeah.
Oh, no, she's a Trump supporter. Oh, here we go. Not a black woman, apparently, if you're a Trump supporter. No True Scotsman fallacy.
Beloved, either way, just be sure you don't forget to go and throw the key away. Now you can call me insane, but Ted Cruz is actually growing on me. Wait,
I just missed it.
Shot wise, he's been freedom of choice while also fighting for.
I get him because I didn't like Ted Cruz when I first. It was my fault. This guy's an arrogant, horrible. Didn't say anything. I say at all. She grew on me. After Trump came in power, it's like something about him. Either I recognised something in him, or he started growing on me, or maybe, like, before Trump became president, remember, I was very fearful, like everybody else. I thought we was almost crying. We think World War III and everything was coming. People, the media got to us. We let it get to us.
Yeah.
And then a couple of friends from America online was telling us some stuff. We researched it and went, oh, damn.
For the First Amendment, which I need for my voice to get out. So no matter how bad that I'm wise, he's been freedom of choice while also fighting for the First Amendment, which I need for my voice.
Love it. Look, that bar needs to be in almost every rap song in one shirt form or another.
To get out.
Every song.
So no matter how bad that I want to hate, I give credit where it's due. I know it's a hot take, but before I'm off the subject, wait, you still ugly. Shit, Arya Stark won't even wear your face. I'll impregnate Melinda Gates.
You just give him an ad hominem tack just so it doesn't seem so much. Yeah. But I like the Lord of the Rings. What's the matter with you, Carl? Game of Thrones little bar in there. That was really cool and subtle.
Yeah.
I was a little slow on that one, but yeah, I like that.
She said my dick was great. I said, shut up, bitch. Get back in the kitchen. Fill my dinner plate. Then I liquid.
See, I'm hoping he said something about Andrew Tate here to go with all the rhyming, because that would go right, wouldn't it, you know?
Mm.
Get in there and fill my dinner plate. Who do you think I am? I'm mother... Andrew Tate. Obviously, I had to bleep the words out there.
They did Bill's estate, pulled their house up with them in them, let them incinerate, gathered up their ashes.
All right, is it better?
Slipped them into some boxes. The FDA approved it and shifted off to the masses. Had some side effects, but they ain't worried about that shit.
FDA... That's also a Russell Brand type thing we're going to be talking about soon, isn't it?
Mm.
Ooh, so glad he mentioned this.
As long as I ain't tell no one and pay my taxes, get your vaccine, shoot up like 15, and don't forget to go collect your free Krispy Kreme. Get tested for fun and get a swab high, because there's nothing quite like huffing ethanol oxide. And Zuckerberg will try to censor my words. Jack Dorsey shadow banning this revenge of the nerds. New rules...
I was swallowing! Oh, that was painful. Ow. Oh, got me laughing as I was swallowing. Beauties. Revenge of the...
Yeah.
Whew! Sorry. Ow. Not cutting this out.
Yeah.
Oh, lemon water.
Who's trying to regulate life as it was? More mandates than gay night at the club, so I'm sorry.
Mandates and
gays at
the
club. Yeah.
New rules trying to regulate life as it was. More mandates than gay night at the club. I'm sorry that I had to come and stop the show before we.
As in man. Yeah, I got it. All right, I'm getting a little slow. I'm sorry. Mandate, Oh my god, when you listen, that's a great bar. That's a great bar. Listen, I was a little slow on that one, right? But that was great. Sorry, Chris. Oh, I wish I caught that. I would have been rocking if I caught that.
Y'all need a motherfucking shot to go anywhere. So someone had to come and rock the boat and say shit that even Tom McDonald won't. And I'm just one.
He just mentioned our boy! It's, when he said it went blank, he said nice thing though, right?
It's the gay night at the club, so I'm sorry that I had to come and stop the show before we all need a motherfucking shot to go anywhere. So someone had to come and rock the boat and say shit that even Tom McDonald won't.
Oh, oh yes. Yeah, that's very sad in there that he said. Yeah, I suppose what we've seen too, I think that's the thing we do love about Tom.
Yeah.
Is like, even though the odd potty word that he blurps out in on his YouTube, it's very, I think, family friendly.
Mm.
I think I prefer Tom McDonald's style because it can get to a bigger audience than Chris can, because Chris is obviously made more for a mature audience.
Yes.
And a bit more stronger audience of mind. So I'm going to say that, yeah, I can't agree with him. Can't agree with him. He doesn't seem to be dissing our boy Tom. I'm going to agree with him. If it was negative, I'd be kicking the bloody thing. No, but... yeah, no, God, I can't agree with him. Tom doesn't see it, all of it in the way he does, but I still think he... No, I agree with him to a certain level. So, Tom fans out there, you unless you've climbed the second biggest mountain in your country with that on your back to play Tom from the top, don't even come to me that you're a hog fan. All right? We're going to put a clip of that on you, right? And go watch that if you want, if you're a hog fan. Yeah? If you're a lover of Tom, go watch that. But, yeah, until you do the same... Balls, yeah, I'll say what I want to say about Tom. But, yeah, I slightly agree with him.
Mm-hmm.
Wish he'd said something nicer, though.
And I'm just one guy with the balls to say what I see. Even if I sound off a ways, all I know is that we're way too lost to save. At this point, I could write a raw...
A lot of people put that bar in there about, like, have the balls to say it, like Eminem, things like that.
Today, shit, but these are my opinions, and I'm allowed to speak them. You want to get the shot? Do you? It's called freedom. Don't, then you don't stop forcing vaccine. Cause to me, that's like pushing pork belly on a vegan. I mean it. Just...
Ho, 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 ho. I like that.
He's clever. He's very clever. He gets the point relatable. Like, he'll say something and then say something to relate to it for you.
Yeah,
it's very clever. The math in his writing is brilliant.
Yeah.
Brilliant. He's got the comedy, everything in there. Like I said, the profanities, I wish he could take out and put something else in there. But like I said, he's appealing to his crowd and his art style. So I have nothing to say on that, really. I'm just saying that if it was me, which it's not.
Disagree with my views, that's all fine. I respect you for yours, respect me for mine. We don't gotta draw a line in the sand or nothing. Just respect the motherfucker that'll stand for something. So keep watching the news and keep trusting the numbers. I'll keep...
You know who he's talking about there, guys? You. Wirgo warriors that will stand for something. Because if you ain't standing for something with a show, then you're just a spectator.
Yeah.
We love spectators. Watch away, guys. We love you guys. You support us. We like that. We want people to stand for things, to make their voices here, like below in the comments. Get down there. Pew, share this for people to see. Like it. Boost us up.
Like,
get us to do the things you want us to do.
Yeah.
We're here to work for you as well as us. And we're only going to prove that soon when we get out on the streets and things like that. As you can see... The British weather, you know, is turning on. I thought we should say Welsh weather, and it's pouring down with rain outside, so we don't even know if we're going to get...
It's quite a few areas in the world that are suffering with storms at the moment.
Yeah. Oh, we're doing things on stuff like that soon as well, because there's a lot we can talk about our weather. A lot. Me and Alyssa have become aware of and speak of. Cloud seeding, weather changing, global warming. don't. Just don't. Don't. I'll destroy you. I just... Wait to me destroy people who talk about global warming. You guys are going to want to watch that. And we destroy them on the street as well.
Mm.
Like, we literally destroy people. Like, to a point you watch them walk away in anger because they look like children. I can promise you all this, guys, that I've done it. She's witnessed it. Many people who know me have witnessed it, and they can't wait for it.
Yeah.
I'm not doing it to harm people or hurt people. I'm just showing them what I'm seeing and comparing their world to mine and seeing which is better. And you will see every single time my world looks like the adult world to their children's world. And I can do that almost every
on
subject
anything.
that people... can disagree with me on, but I am here to learn. So I mean, when you get someone that's going to stand up to me on the street or anywhere and tell me what is what, in a way that I'm going to understand, that is by asking me questions, you watch them change my mind. You watch the ones that actually try to tell me, though. That's funny.
Digging for truth and tell them what I discover as they cancel motherfuckers just for raising their hand. I'll pull my megaphone out and get to taking a stand. Raw thoughts.
Again, his videos are graphic as well, but, you know. Right, guys, so we will put the warnings up for the graphic video, the swearing, and just one last point to cover before I do that is that me and Lissa, I believe we've spoken about this before, that we don't really condone violences and stuff. If I said to you, babe, just before we go into the positive things and everything like this, if we clear the air, mm-hmm. your moment, and just say, oh, by the way, I think that's the end of the track. The red bar's right at
yes,
the end.
Right.
Yeah, that's full. Yeah. Right, so, look, listen, guys, this is what we're going to say to you. Quickly before I do this a minute, just to say that I, listen, give your own things. You can either agree or say your own thing in a minute. I do not condone the video or some of the words to this track because I think that there's no need for them. I think he's put it in specially to be different and everything like that. I completely accept and appreciate what he's done. I love his art form.
Yeah.
But it's just not something I would personally do myself. I don't get to tell Chris how to do his stuff. And Chris don't get to tell me how to do my stuff. We can advise each other tops if he ever is inclined to. And I don't think he'd ever listen to me anyway. He seems like a guy who likes his raw form. But that's not something we would agree with. We wouldn't do that, right? We don't think that would be something we'd do. I'd probably go more along the Tom McDonald route and go like a video like Tom does,
yeah?
And I'd probably do the lyrics in which way Tom does. That's why I'm... Tom relates to me more because I think that I would be more want to be more relatable to everybody rather than a narrow group.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
He is relating it to a narrow group. And if he even claims he's doing this for children, then I would never watch him again.
Mm-mm.
If he says this material is for children, then Chris Webby would then fall to the bottom of the pile for me. I've never watched his stuff, no matter how much I agreed with anything, because there'd be an element in there that stamps on my underlying core foundations of who I am. And things above that, like the potty mouth and things like that, within this realm of art that he's doing, is fine. I can do that. But as soon as he advertises it for children and things like that, then that wouldn't be fine to me. Same as other certain things, which is not what this episode's about. Would you agree, or do you want something to add to that?
Completely agree.
Right, but so, Ryan, there you go first then. What did you think of the video?
Amazing. Absolutely incredible. Factual to me. You just hit the nail on the head on... Hit the nail on the head with a lot of subjects there.
Yeah.
Just in that one song alone. Yeah.
Just that one song.
Yeah, that blew my mind.
Right. I won't try not to put you on the spot because it's the first time listening to it. Would you say there's a bar, a line in there that stands out most for you at all or relates to you more?
There's too many.
Or is it too many?
I can't specify one in particular. They're all great, to be honest.
Do you want to name a couple or do you want to just leave it to listen to it again and find the ones you like?
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't want to put you on the spot because you just listen to it. And even me is coming in trying to remember the things he said.
Yeah.
But I'm glad he brought up certain topics in there that I wanted to.
Mask. Wiping your ass. That's what I felt like doing.
Me and Lisa never took one jab, didn't wear a mask once, never lined up, didn't do anything like that. I wouldn't allow it to. I won't tell you what happened because I don't believe in people using powers they don't understand. With great power does come great responsibility, but I see it the other way around. With great responsibility comes great power.
Yeah.
In fact, they both go hand in hand either way. People don't say the last one.
Yeah.
They always say, with great power comes great responsibility. And with great responsibility comes great power. That's the end of that one. And if you don't see it like that, then I don't know what to tell you. But like, my raw thoughts on this was, it's still the same. I wouldn't have done it. I'm not going to go on that. But everything in there, I loved.
Yeah.
I loved the comical value that he has in it, writing his music, because that attaches to people. It attaches to you. Because what resonates in you, what wasn't one of the most powerful things you do is laugh.
Mm.
Don't understand that yet. Find a way to be happy. I don't know who you are, so I can't tell you. Every individual has his own way of being happy. So find a way of being happy, and then laughter will become one of the most powerful things you do. And he's doing that. The mathematics of his track is unbelievably brilliant. I love how the words flow. He does, in a couple of parts, alter his tone to make the word go, but in the majority of it, it's just pure poetic lyrical genius. Have I seen better? Of course. Have I seen worse? Of course. I don't like using the word better or worse. They're your words. I'd like to say, have I seen different? Yes. Have I seen different that relates to me more? Yes. Have I seen different that relates to me in different ways? Yes. But does this stand on its own and hold its own merit? Yeah, definitely. This, to me, seems unique. Reminds me a little bit of Eminem, but more, like I said, more, how would I say it for this guy? More personal, more raw, go on, yeah, I got more raw thoughts. Eminem seems a bit more mainstream. Why am I picking on Eminem? He's probably one of the most famous rappers I know today, alongside, like, obviously, the boys, people we love, and the oldies in the past. But, yeah, I'd say I'm definitely going to listen to more. Definitely, definitely. Thank you, whichever Wirgo Warrior you were, that put this for us to look at. As soon as we seen something like that in the comments, I said, all right, let's check this out. So when people put things in there, I'll check them out. Sometimes I have written them down. I lost the list I wrote down. I've looked back through. We found raw thoughts. Someone did put something else down, but I can't remember what it was. Another request. But like, if you again, if you're watching this and you're like, oh, these guys will listen to us and they will put the, let us know. We'll do your whatchamacallums, your requests. Whew. I need a chill, I do. Right then, I need a chill, I do. I put the Welsh accent coming out. This is what Welshies sound like. You guys, I know you're not thinking, what's that he's doing? Well, this is a Welsh accent. This is where we come from. With my ADHD, it talks like it's because I speak really fast. I had a military career. Supposed to say, thank you for your service, woman. No, don't call me a woman. No, but for my military past, I pick up all sorts of accents and I mimic people. So I don't really have an accent, but the Welsh obviously comes through for those who are not Welsh. But around here, you can hear people and they speak like this, they do. Because they're very, very Welshy.
Hey,
boyo, how are you doing? Oh, went a little Pakistani then, didn't I? A little bit. And that's another thing. A lot of people confuse the Pakistani accent with the Welsh accent, which is, I've seen a lot of English, a lot of English people do when I was over there. And I was like, God, you sound Pakistani, not Welsh. Welsh. Yeah. Right, so guys, I think that's going to be it for Raw Thoughts. There are Raw Thoughts on it. We just wanted to do a quick review, talk through it and see our thing. I think we spoke all the way through with everything. We'll leave it there.
Yeah.
Tell us what you thought of Chris Webby's Raw Thoughts. Let us know down below. Let us also know if you haven't heard it and your first time hearing it with us and what you thought. Tell us if there's any other Chris Webby songs you'd like us to listen to next or your favourite artist. This part of Wirgo is just us, just me and Liz, just goofing around, talking about stuff. And I know it's coming to you first. Wait till the rest of it comes. You'll really enjoy that. Wirgo Warriors, harmony.